Now, if I were to say, your sense perceptions are the only means by which you can have knowledge of physical reality. It looks strange that if sense perceptions are the only reason, nobody knows the world except through sense perceptions. You have no sense perception, the world disappears. Sense perceptions, are they picking up a created world or are they creating the world? Very old question, it's not new. Philosophers have been asking this question for thousands of years. When we look at a tree, is the tree there and therefore we see it, or we are seeing therefore the tree is there? Which is the cause, which is the effect? Is the seeing of the tree the cause of the tree, or the tree is the cause of our seeing it? Where does it start? Now, understanding that cause and effect follow according to our brains at this time in the physical world, our brains think cause has to happen first. And then effect comes. So we say, if a tree is there, we can see it. Somebody says, therefore, somebody has to bring a tree in front of you before you can see it. But the bringing of the tree is also the same as a tree. It's just an experience and perception. So can we see inside and then the tree comes? Or the tree has to come before we can see it? Old question. Do we have a real answer to this? Because they have been debating. Those who say tree has to be there, the world has to be there before sense perceptions can pick it up, we call them the materialists. They believe in the truth, existence of matter. And those who say no, we have no idea if they exist outside or not. Our seeing is the only evidence we have that there is something. Maybe seeing is the real reason for creating things we are seeing. They are called the idealists. The debate between the materialists and idealists has been going on, and I believe it will keep on going on till they go inside to find out the answer. They don't go inside. They discuss outside. Now, if you were to go inside, you will find the answer, which will surprise you. The answer you will find inside is the sense perceptions create your universe. Now, it can be put like this. I'm trying to give a little scientific touch to what I am explaining. So the scientists don't have to say, oh, this is all nonsense. So I'm bringing it a little science. Look at what vision is seeing. What's the definition of vision in the single, in our eye? What do the scientists say? What do medical professionals say? What do those study anatomy of the eye? What do they say? How do we see? They say we can only see things if light falls on it. If it's dark, the eyes cannot see. So there's a requirement. A requirement that will not exist at other levels, but in this physical world, there's a requirement is you can see nothing in total darkness. Light must fall upon an object before you can see it. Then what happens? Scientifically, what happens? When light falls, light has got many colors, looks white because it's all combined. The rainbow is one light spread out into seven colors. Light has many colors. So when light falls upon an object, the scientists tell us the object absorbs the colors of the light. And what it cannot absorb, it reflects back. That means supposing somebody is wearing a red shirt, it does not mean that the color is red. The absorbed color is all colors of the rainbow except red. So red is being reflected back. Okay, we see shapes and colors, and they come in near parallel rays to our eyes. There the eyes use three or four systems, like the cornea, like the liquid behind the cornea, the aqueous humor, a lens, and inside the lens, a vitreous humor, thicker liquid, and then there's a retina behind on which the image of what we are seeing because of the light coming in forms an inverted image. That's the explanation. A retina is nothing more then extension of an optic nerve coming from our brain out to the eye contains two types of things, rods and cones. One can distinguish the color, one can distinguish the shape, and that message falling on the retina is carried by the optic nerve to the head. And in the head, if we are conscious and awake, we can see. A simple explanation of seeing. Supposing somebody's optic nerve is cut, he can't see, no matter what. Supposing one has an image already in the head, the optic nerve will carry it out. And the optic nerve will carry and have the image, and the person will see that. We will say he is hallucinating. People, there are lots of people hallucinating right now. We are treating them for mental illness. Is it possible we are all hallucinating? And the one who hallucinates different, we are treating him, the rest are okay? Because the process is the same. Now you imagine if the retina of the eye was so programmed to create the images it sees, all the images will look exactly as they look now. That's the only process by which it goes in. Supposing nothing is happening on the retina, but the optic center, so where the optic nerve originates from in the brain, that can create the images, we still see the same thing. If the optic nerve is doing nothing, the consciousness, the wakeful state we are in, is generating an image, the rest will be exactly the same. The image will be on the retina, and we see the world as it is.